Hi guys, I'm Dr. Pratik Thakkar. I'm an MD dermatologist and I own the Center of Dermatology Excellence in Borivali and I practice in Viliparle. I'm here to talk to you about lasers, a very brief overview about what these actually are, the main misconceptions about lasers, and the laser about which we face the most number of questions, that's your hair removal laser. In dermatology, we use lasers for multiple indications like a permanent hair reduction, pigment reduction, tattoo removal, rejuvenation, skin tightening, treatment of scars, burning out moles, warts, and a lot of other things. Now, two things that you need to understand about lasers so that you are not afraid of getting lasers done in the future are: one, lasers are nothing but energy delivered in the form of light. Now, as laymen, we all know that light is of different colors. The scientific word for this color is wavelength. The wavelength of a ray of light determines what color that light would be. And laser is nothing but a very high intensity of light of a single wavelength. This wavelength determines what will be the target of the laser and what depth it will work. Now for you, what you need to remember is, lasers are not emitting radiation. Lasers are not emitting something that is going to get inside your body, that is going to go through and through your body, and that is something that's going to harm you. Lasers, like I said, are nothing but energy delivered in the form of light. They go only up to a certain depth of the skin, deliver energy at the target, like the root of the hair, and that's it. So these lasers are not going to harm you, they are not going to get inside you. Other thing, the wavelength of light used in lasers is very, very far from the wavelength of light that cause cancer. We've heard of a lot of skin cancers due to ultraviolet light. A lot of your doctors advise that you should use sunscreen. The wavelength of light used in lasers is very different from the wavelength that causes these cancers. And in fact, there is no risk of any skin diseases at all. Okay, so now that you understand what lasers are, let's look into very briefly about the different types of lasers. One is your permanent hair reduction laser. A lot of people want to get it done. Once they are convinced about the safety of the laser, they want to understand whether the results are permanent, whether the hairs will be completely gone, with how painful it will be. So here's the thing, yes, the results are permanent, but it takes multiple sessions. You'll see a lot of ads claiming that you need 4 or 5 sessions for complete hair removal. That is not true. Depending on your hormonal profile, depending on your skin type, you may require anywhere between 5 to 12 sessions of lasers on an average. Some people with certain medical conditions where we have to use very low energies may even require more. But yes, once your required sessions of lasers are done, the results are permanent. Now, what to expect from these results? One, there will be a permanent reduction in the number of hairs. 100% of the hairs will not go. There will be a few hairs left, but these hairs will be so thin that it will not matter. So second, there will be a permanent reduction in the thickness of hairs. And third, there will be a much, much slower rate of regrowth. So even when you've not completed your requisite number of sessions, suppose you've done 2 or 3 sessions, you will notice that your hair doesn't grow back as fast as it used to. So if your first 2 or 3 sessions are done at, say, 4 weeks or 5 weeks intervals, your latter sessions might require once in 2 months, once in 3 months, and so on. About the technology. Now, laser hair removal machines have been of different types, the IPL, the diode, the NDI. The latest one is something called triple wavelength. Now this triple wavelength laser has an advantage in the sense it targets your hairs at 3 different levels. Your normal layer, your normal laser targets only a certain layer of your skin which has the main chunk of the root. Now imagine if you have few hairs that are finer, few hairs that are deeper. These will be skipped. That is why some people have disappointing results with the lasers. Your triple wavelength laser will target three different levels and hence will be significantly more effective against your finer hairs as well as compared to your other lasers. Now let me show you what this triple wavelength laser is. Alright, do you see this? This handpiece of the laser has wavelength, has three different wavelengths, so it will target all the three levels. Now this tip of the laser, this is where that energy comes from. And the newer lasers have a very strong cooling ability of these tips, giving you a lot of comfort, very minimal pain, reducing the chances of burns very significantly. Burns with lasers are almost unheard of these days. Okay. Now another question that people commonly ask me is, how young can you start the hair removal lasers? Now, as far as safety goes, you can start it at any age. There is no health hazard with this laser. However, I recommend that you start after the age of 16 or 17 so that your hair growth is a little more stable and the laser works more effectively and you require lesser number of sessions. If you have any more questions about the laser, please feel free to contact me. I'm sure you'll find the contact details in the link where you found this video. Now, the next laser I'll be talking about is your pigmentation laser. It's called the Q-Switch NDAG laser. One of my favorites, it basically bursts pigment. It can be used for more stubborn, significant pigmentations like your tattoo removal. Again, something that requires multiple sessions, but very effective. It can be used for certain pigmented patches on your skin, or you can simply use it for rejuvenation, and that's where it gives the most satisfying results. You have a function to attend. You don't want your skin to look dull. You go to a parlor, you get a facial done, and then you get a bleach done, then you get polishing, and then you apply makeup. What this laser does is it instantly takes away the excessive tan and pigmentation from your skin, makes your skin instantly look much brighter, much fresher. It also bleaches and burns out all the finer hairs on your face. Now, unlike a chemical bleach that you get done in the parlors, which makes your hair white and visible like a lion's mane, this laser burns them out and your bleached hair shed off. So it gives you a much more natural look and your skin is instantly ready within a matter of 2 hours to attend any function. So, of course, for best results, for more permanent results, you need to do it much more regularly. Again, let me show you that laser as well. So this is what my pigmentation laser looks like. It's called the Q-Switch NDAG laser. The laser I have is called the Iris S Plus. It's a US FDA approved laser by a very reputed Korean company. Now, lasers, apart from pigmentation in hair, can also be used for treatment of scars. Let me show you that laser as well. Whether it's acne, whether it's any other scar, whether it's stretch marks, whether you want to burn moles out, this CO2 laser is the way to go. And since I wanted to keep this video brief, let us stick to these three basic lasers that form the core of dermatology practice. There are many more, I'm sure. Your dermat will be able to help you out with them when you want to consult. But the main reason why I'm doing this video is you do not need to be afraid of lasers. They are safe. Of course, you need a good amount of training to maintain the safety. Please, please, please get lasers done by a qualified dermatologist only. There are a lot of unqualified people doing these lasers these days. And that's where all the complications happen. Most lasers today are pain-free, including the hair removal laser, which causes very minimal discomfort, unlike the lasers before. And if you are visiting a qualified dermatologist rather than getting it done by somebody who doesn't have a degree in dermatology, rest assured you will not be asked to do a laser unless it is actually going to benefit you and unless you don't have any contraindications to go against the laser.
To book an appointment with a cosmetologist or a dermatologist in your area, please visit www.skinandhairacademy.in.